In arithmetic sequence problems, you're given a sequence of numbers such as 2, 8, 14, 20. The first term is a sub 1, second term is a sub 2, the third term is a sub 3, and the fourth term is a sub 4. This goes on forever. Thus we have a sub n to represent the position of the terms. So in these problems, it will ask you, for example, what is the 20th term for this arithmetic sequence? Thus, it is asking for the a sub 20. There is an arithmetic sequence formula, which is a sub n equals a sub 1 plus d times n minus 1. The d is the difference from one number to the next number in the sequence of numbers, also called the common difference. So we need to calculate the common difference, d. The difference between 2 and 8 is 6, because 8 minus 2 is 6. The difference between 8 and 14 is 6, because 14 minus 8 is 6. The difference between 14 and 20 is 6, because 20 minus 14 is 6. Thus, our common difference, d, is 6 for this arithmetic sequence of numbers. A sub 1 is the first number of the sequence, in this case 2. Thus our formula now looks like this: a sub n equals 2 plus 6 times n minus 1. Now we have everything we need to use the TI-84 plus CE graphing calculator to find what is the 20th term for this arithmetic sequence, or any term that we want. Press the second button here, then the stat button here. This window pops up. Go to ops here. Go down to number 5, sequence. Press the enter button here. This screen pops up. The first line expression. Here, type in this part of our equation. But instead of using the variable n, we will use the variable x, which is this button here. 2 plus 6 times x minus 1. Go down to the next line by pressing the down arrow key here. The variable that we are using is the x, so enter a x by pressing this button here. Go down to the next line, start. The start and end are the beginning term and the ending term you want to calculate and display. For example, let us calculate a sub 1 to a sub 4, which are these numbers here, the first four terms of our sequence. So for start, we will enter a 1. And for end, we will enter a 4. For step, I always use 1. Go down to paste. We do not enter anything here. We just press the enter button. This will paste our equation onto the next screen. Press the enter button. This is our sequence equation with the conditions. This is our equation. This x means x is our variable. This 1 and 4 means we want to display terms 1 to term 4, also known as a sub 1 to a sub 4. This one is the step 1. Now press the enter button to get our answer. And there is our result, the first four terms of our sequence. You can see it is the same numbers in our original sequence. This lets us know that our equation is correct. Now let's go back and find the 20th term, or a sub 20, in our sequence. We'll go back to the sequence equation by pressing the second button here and the stat button here. Go to ops. Go to 5, sequence. We just want the 20th term in the sequence, so enter a 20 here for start. Go down to n and also enter a 20. Leave step as 1 and go down to paste and press the enter key. Our sequence equation with the new parameters appears. Press the enter key again and there's the answer, 116. A sub 20, or the 20th term of this sequence, is 116. We're going to do one more problem. This problem involves negative numbers. Press the clear button here to clear this screen. We're going to work with this arithmetic sequence, 3, negative 2, negative 7, and negative 12. Here's the difference between these numbers, a negative 5, thus D equals a negative 5. Remember the arithmetic sequence formula? Plugging in a 3 for our A sub 1 and a negative 5 for D, the common difference, we get this for our equation. Now go to the sequence page, second button, stat button, ops tab, enter the expression. Remember, when entering a negative number, use this negative sign here and not the minus sign. For the start and end, we'll enter 1 and 4. This is the first term to the fourth term. Keep the step at 1. Go down to paste and press the enter key. Here is our expression with the parameters. Press the enter key again, and there is our answer. Our equation is correct because it matches our sequence. Okay, that is it. That is how to work with arithmetic sequence on the TI-84 plus CE graphing calculator. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and please subscribe to this channel.